Have you ever wanted more quality and flexibility while working? What you need is smart objects inside of Photoshop. And what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna use potatoes to explain to you how smart objects work. Then I'm gonna give you 7 tips with smart objects. So if you wanna work faster with higher quality and more flexibility, keep watching. Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from photoshopcafe.com, the very best place to learn Photoshop and Lightroom. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at photoshopcafe. I've got a ton of images that I'm posting there all the time. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you smart objects, because I've had a lot of people say they like smart objects or they want to like smart objects. They're not aware of all the things they can do or necessarily how they work. So I'm going to explain them really simply right now using a potato. So imagine this little potato here is your image that you're working on. It's a layer, whatever it could be. It could be cut out or it could be a flattened layer. Now, the thing is, if I want to paint this blue and I paint this blue, this potato is now going to be blue. And it's going to be very hard for me to get rid of that effect. Or if I want to apply a rubber texture or something to it, it's going to be very difficult. In fact, almost impossible to get that off there. However, if I take a bag and I put the potato inside the bag, now I can put all kinds of textures, whatever I want. I can paint this bag and, you know, of course I can make it nice and small, same shape as the potato, whatever. And then this is gonna look blue. It's gonna give that blue appearance or whatever I wanna do to it, but it's not gonna affect the potato itself. It's just going to apply whatever I put on it. Now, here's the thing. This is your pixel. This is your smart object. So here's the thing about the smart object. I can also put more than one potato in there. So I could put more than one layer in there, and I can make these adjustments. And at any time, if I want to change my mind, I can open up this bag, which would be a smart object. I can pull my potato out. So here's the other thing. I could have 2 of these. So maybe I have 2 smart objects. I have another potato here. And I can put them both together and put these inside another bag. So essentially what I've done is I've nested 2 smart objects inside another smart object. Now, if those bags were painted blue, they would still be blue. But if I painted this one red, now it's going to have red over the top. And if I ever want to go back, I can always go back inside that bag. I can pull those bags out. I can pull the potatoes out. So that's essentially how smart objects work. Now, these images I'm using for these examples are from Adobe Stock. I encourage you to download images from Adobe Stock because you can search for them and download them directly with inside of Photoshop. If you want to play around and experiment, you can download a watermarked version. And at any time, you can choose to license that image and use it in your commercial projects. So before we jump into Photoshop really quick, I have a question for you. What is your main use of Photoshop? You use it for design, photography? Let me know. Drop it in the comment underneath. I'm really curious to see how you guys are using Photoshop. So here we are right now, and we've got this butterfly. And what I'm going to do first of all, the very first thing I'm going to show you about smart objects is how they maintain quality. So I'm going to duplicate this by holding the Alt or the Option key, and I'm going to drag out a copy of the butterfly. Notice we have 2 of them on separate layers. This top one, I'm going to right click, choose to convert to a smart object. You know it's a smart object because this little icon appears in the corner. So essentially what we've done right now, this is our butterfly. We've dropped it inside the bag and we have now got a smart object. So if it's in the bag, that means I can't directly edit this picture. So let me say I grab something hideous like the eraser tool and I try to erase it. Notice I can't. Now, if I double click the smart object, notice what it does is it opens inside a new document and here is our butterfly. If I wanted to erase it now, I could. So we can make any changes to it, and if we save it there, then we go back into the document and we're back inside our smart object or our plastic bag. Okay, that's the basics. Okay, let me show you something here. If I select both of these layers and I scale them down. Control T or Command T on Mac for free transform. And I'm gonna drop these way down. Let's make them real small here. Hit enter. Excellent. Now why don't we scale them back up? Control or Command T. And they look blurry, but we apply it and boom. Look what happens here. You can see the one that was inside the smart object has maintained its quality. It hasn't lost anything. Meanwhile, this other one has deteriorated a little bit. In fact, if we zoom in at 100%, look at the difference in quality. That's the one without the smart object, and that's the one with the smart object. And of course, the more you transform the image, the more it loses quality. Maybe you weren't even aware of that fact when you're scaling things up and down, you're deteriorating. Here's the thing, if I do it a couple more times, it's gonna get worse, I'll show you. Make it real small, Control T, make it bigger. Let's make it real huge, Control T, bring it down again. And look at that, see how the one that's not in the smart object is really losing its quality. Smart object one, not concerned at all. Let's have a look at the second benefit of working with a smart object. We can apply filters. And when we apply filters, they become smart filters. So if we choose filter, and I'm gonna choose liquify, it's gonna apply the liquify just like normal. And what I'm gonna do, why don't we just give this spiky wings for now? It'll be just kind of fun. New species of monarch butterfly. I'm sure there's probably a butterfly like this that exists somewhere. All right, and then we're gonna click OK. And now what we've done is we've created this new species of butterfly. It's called the spiky monarch. Now the cool thing about working with the smart filter versus a regular filter is we see under here it says smart filter, we can turn that off at any time and it hides the effect of that smart filter. And if we decide to remove our liquify, we just simply right click here and we delete the smart filter and that takes it away. We can make copies of these and transform them without losing any quality. So let's have a look right now. I'm just gonna hit Control T, Command T. We're gonna drop down the size of this. And why don't we drag it over here? So what I wanna do now is I wanna make a bunch of butterflies. So the way to do that is to hold down the Alt or the Option key and we're gonna drag them out. So I'm just gonna hit Control T, right click. Let's do a free transform. And we can have one over there. Alright, so now we've made lots of copies of these smart objects. Now here's the cool thing about smart objects. All of these are linked. So if I change one, it's gonna change them all. Let me demonstrate. Let's grab this one here. I'm gonna control click or command click to select it. Double click it. Notice we go inside the bag. Now we're inside this bag and we're gonna make some changes. Or inside the smart object. Why don't we do some hue saturation adjustments? So let's apply a hue saturation adjustment layer. And by the way, adjustment layers are a great way to work inside of smart objects because it keeps everything non-destructive. And if you don't fully understand adjustment layers, I've got a fantastic tutorial in the comments. I'm gonna give you a link underneath to that tutorial. All right, so why don't we change the color just so we can see how this works. We'll do something like, I don't know, let's drag it over and make it yellowish color. Notice it's orange there, and then I apply this, it makes it yellow. If we go back here, notice they are all orange. Now, if I save this, and I close it, we go back, notice they've all updated and all of them now are yellow. So that's another great thing about smart objects is you change one, you change them all. But what if you don't want to change them all? But there's a way where you can create a smart object that works independently than the rest, and I'll show you how to do that. So what we're gonna do is under here, to create a new smart object, we're gonna right click on this, And now we're going to choose to new smart object via copy. Let's pull this out a little bit so we can see the numbers, and we can see number 12, that's our newest one. And we want to make sure we pull that out. Okay, let's go in and adjust this smart object. Double click, go in here. And what we'll do is something radical, like we'll invert it. So I'm selecting that layer, hitting Command I, hit save. And now we go back and notice that only that smart object has changed. It hasn't affected the rest. And that's because we did it via copy. Let me delete that. And now I'm going to show you another thing. What if we want to do some adjustments on these? Even though we can adjust these independently, the other thing we can do is we can select all of these butterflies and we can right click and we can convert to a smart object. We'll call it butterflies. So essentially what we've done now is we've nested all of these smart objects into one object. And notice we can move it around. And of course, if we want to duplicate it, we could do that to get more butterflies very, very quickly. And now if we wanted, we could select both of these and hit convert to smart object again. And then we've nested them once again. So what we've done is we've taken this bag and we've put it inside this bag. And then we've put these bags inside this bag. So that's the equivalent of what we're doing. So now anything we do here is going to affect all of those butterflies together. However, we can still get to those individual ones. All right, so let's have a look at making an adjustment here. So if we just go under the filter and we get a camera raw filter. And maybe we want to do something here with the colors. Maybe we want to just bring down the contrast a little bit. Maybe make them a little bit brighter. We're also going to reduce the blacks. Make them a little softer there and a little touch of negative clarity. And then we're just going to click OK. So now we've adjusted all these butterflies. But if we want to get into the individual ones, we can double click. Notice there's the two sets of butterflies. And if we want to get into the individual ones, it doesn't matter which one of these we click on, because remember we duplicated it, so they're exactly the same. So we double click here on the smart object, and now we're in here, and there's our individual butterfly. So if we double click on this one, remember we made the adjustments? If I turn that off and hit save, we go there, look at that. We want to hit save on that one, save that one. And then we go back and all our butterflies are orange again. So you can see how incredibly flexible these smart objects are. Now there's more things you can do with smart objects. You can also use them with type layers. You can drop in Illustrator files in there, and those vector files you can actually double click and it'll go into Illustrator. You can edit. There's a ton of different things that you can do with these smart objects. So let's do one more thing. Let's go back in. And now that we've got these documents open, we can just click here and go to our individual butterfly if we like. Why don't we select it? We're going to go under filter. And let's go back under liquify. And I feel like I want to get these spikes back again. Then we click OK. Let's save that. Close it out. Notice those are all spiky. Let's save that. Notice all of these are spiky because that's double of those. Remember, it's applied all the way. We save that. Then we go back to our top and notice now they're all spiky. So you can see how incredibly time-saving these smart objects can be as well as preserving your quality, giving you flexibility, and nothing is affected permanently. We can go back and we can change anything we want at any time. So bear in mind here, I'm not trying to win any design awards with this particular composition. What I'm trying to do is explain to you exactly how smart objects work. So I hope you've learned something. If you have, drop a comment. Let me know what you've learned that's new. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to give you links underneath where you can grab these images from Adobe Stock and follow along with the same images that I'm using. And also, you know, don't forget you can grab all kinds of images from Adobe Stock and play around and experiment with them. And I'm also going to give you a link underneath where you can get 10 free images. And also I'm going to give you another link where you can become a contributor. Anyone can become a contributor. It's actually very easy. Just follow the link underneath, sign up, and then you can get your photos in front of millions of people and make some extra revenue. So anyway, if you like this tutorial, smash that like button into dust. And if you enjoy these kind of tutorials, hit that subscribe button right now and that little notification bell. I do a new tutorial every single Tuesday, and occasionally I'll also add one on a Saturday. So thanks guys for watching. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.